2018, the genre dominated charts with artists from all over Latin America.
So true, Cassie. To celebrate an amazing year of Latin music, we have Grecia Lopez with us rounding up six Latin artists who had major, major moments in 2018.
Hey, girl.
This year was huge for Latin music, of course. I've been talking about it all year long. This year, we saw incredible growth with the Latin genre, dominating charts, the news, the airways. They were everywhere. So let's get right into it.
Let's get into it.
My favorite, Maluma.
Everybody's favorite. We love Maluma.
Reactions just says it all. Yes. Everybody loves Maluma. He is the heartthrob for 2018. He's only 24 years old.
Wow.
And he is killing it. The Colombian singer released his third studio album, Fame, this year in May, and it had riveting reviews. And I was actually lucky enough to go to his Fame Tour concert.
How was he in person?
It did not disappoint.
Okay?
The whole concert, he had all of us women on our feet.
Literally
like this, like, can I just please touch you? And he was flirting with everybody. Because, you know, artists, they walk around. He was walking around winking, going like
but
this.
But he's taken,
like
right? He's been hitting
all the
red carpets.
During his concert, what he does is he pulls somebody from the audience. Mm-hmm. So, you know, going into this concert, I was like, I could probably get pulled on stage with Maluma tonight. Of course, I didn't. I was so jealous of the girl because she went up there and he was like, give me a kiss. And she said no. She said no because she had a boyfriend. I was like, girl, who cares if you have a boyfriend? If Maluma's asking you for a kiss.
That's a hard position to be. Your boyfriend could have been in the audience.
This is the Maluma effect. So going back to his 2018, he was honored with the Extraordinary Evolution Award at the Latin American Music Awards. And we were actually with him backstage the day before. And he told us that, you know, what he's doing with his career, of course, he's very thankful for everything. But what he's doing with his career is for the future generation, for the future rappers, the future trap urban artists. And even though he went, even though he had the Extraordinary Evolution Award there, his biggest moment was the Latin Grammys because he won his very first Latin Grammy this year, and this is how he celebrated.
No tengo el Grammy que me lo envían, pero miren. Papi, ganamos un Grammy, familia.
I love it, and I love that it was just like a genuine reaction.
Yes.
It was just on cloud nine, so big congratulations to him. Moving on to another Colombian beauty, Miss Carol G. Okay. This girl had an unbelievable 2018. She is 27-year-old, and she really put her name on the map this year with her unapologetic lyrics, and she's dominated the Latin industry as a female. Because, again, we all know that the Latin genre is a lot of male, and she's coming in very strong with her lyrics because she's all about female empowerment. Mm-hmm. So this year, she actually received the Inspire Award at the 31st Annual Hispanic Heritage Award Ceremony. Because again, she's all about female empowerment. All she wants to do is spread positivity. And you can see that in her lyrics too.
Yeah.
You know, like she likes to, you know, she wants to like dominate the men and take care of the men and just be on top because that's what she's all about. And she was also a big winner at the Latin Grammy. She took home her first Latin Grammy as well for Best New Artist. And her speech was so cute. She took on her dad up at the stage. She calls him Papa G. So if you follow her on Instagram, you're familiar that she's always like, Papa G, Papa G. And what I loved about her speech is that she gave a shout out to J Balvin, which is another artist who dominated 2018. She said, you know what? When I saw J Balvin win his first Latin Grammy 4 years ago, she's like, I imagined myself here.
Girl.
So it's crazy. You know, just how you said earlier.
It's all about manifesting and putting it into the universe.
And it's visualization, you know, the power of it.
I mean, look, it happened.
Exactly, it happened. And you know, something else she found in 2018 was love.
Hey!
Right now, she's dating another Latin artist called Anuel AA. So I'm so happy for her. So girl, we'll see what 2019 has in store for you.
Good things.
Moving on to J Balvin, another superstar from Colombia. He had a stellar 2018. Now, J Balvin's been around for a few years, but 2018 was killer for him. Mm-hmm. He released his fifth album, Vibras, as well as landing his first number one spot on the Billboard Hot 100 with his song I Like It, because everybody
likes it.
Such a good song with Cardi B and Bad Bunny. But he performed with Miss Beyonce at Coachella, And there they are. He actually crashed her set, and they formed Mi Gente. Before Mi Gente.
Love that.
And it was crazy. The crowd went wild because for anybody who collabs with Beyonce, it's going to be big.
But Beyonce looks giddy, too.
She something about J Balvin, you know, his album Vibras, which is vibes. It's like just as soon as J Balvin gets into the studio, you're like, okay, I'm feeling your vibes, J Balvin. But it was huge for him because not only it was Beyonce, but it got him a lot of mainstream attention, you know, because he was breaking the barriers between being big in Latin America and crossing into the English market.
Right.
So great for him. And he, you know, something else is that he made his rounds at the late night shows, which is something big that not a lot of Spanish speaking
get to even do.
You know, just this week he was on Fallon and he's performed on another late night shows throughout the year. But it's again, that's showing that the Latin music wave is coming.
Yes.
And girl, it's here to stay.
I hope so. When we did the Latin Grammys, I realized that. I'm like, where has this been?
It was huge. Yeah, it was huge. And I'm so happy to be in the middle of it all.
Of course.
Next up, we have our girl, Becky G, who we, of course, not stop talking about. She's just unstoppable.
This girl has glowed up.
I know. We've literally seen her from like singing in the shower to now seeing Pijama. So it's, I mean, look at her now. She's
so
just
beautiful.
So beautiful, grown into her womanhood. Beautiful Mexican-American. And 2018 was a year full of firsts for her. It was her first time performing at Madison Square Garden, which is a big goal for a lot of artists. It was her first time collaborating with a ranchera song. And she also dove into the country roots. And you spoke to her, right?
I did. I caught up with her at the Spotify Genius Awards. And I asked her, because she has a song out right now with Kane Brown. And that was, like you said, her first time. So I asked her, you know, was that intimidating diving into country?
Right.
And she said it sure was. But, you know, the country music industry has embraced her, and it's a great song.
And I was actually with her just last week. She gave a free concert for her fans here in Los Angeles, and she spoke about it too. She's like, you know what, there's just a weird stigma about artists from genre crossing into genre. She's like, I need to stop being scared to crossing over different genres, because that's what music is about. Music is unity, you know. Music is about family and unifying everybody.
It's one language at the end of the day, and I mean, only artists limit themselves. We've seen Cardi crossing over too into the Latin genre, which to me put her on a whole nother level. I mean, she's half Dominican, so it's her right to do it, but at the same time, it's just...
And the picture that you guys just saw with Becky G, she was holding on two Latin American Music Awards. This girl was just unstoppable this year. She actually hosted the Latin AMAs for the second year in a row. She took home two awards, and she's killing it.
Another female who's killing it. One of my favorites.
Another female who's killing it is Rosalia.
Rosalia.
I mean, if there is one single breakout Latin artist this year, it is Rosalia. She's 25 years old. She got a lot of attention for her folk and pop mixture genre. And you know what, when E.T. spoke to her at the Latin Grammys, and she was saying that she's just thankful that she is able to perform music that she's comfortable with, because you know, a lot of labels like to control what the artist puts out, but she's like, you know what, I'm happy. And a big winner as well at the Latin Grammys. She was the most female nominated there, and she took home two awards.
So good, I love her.
Last but not least, Gracia, who do we have? One of my favorites?
Bad Bunny.
The
Bad Bunny. He was just, 2018 was like a movie for him. He became a household name without even releasing an album. The only thing he's been doing is been collaborating, featuring. He does not have an album yet. He got on mainstream media with J-Lo, with Drake, with Cardi, J Bobby, Nicki Jam, and so on and so forth. And of course, E.T. also spoke with him earlier this year, and he just says that this new wave of Latin music coming into the English market is just making sure that us Latinos are represented.
You all are represented. This is so good. I want more and more and more. Keep it coming.
It's coming. It's coming. We're coming.
It for sure is, and we can't wait to see what Latin music has in store for 2019.
I'm so ready.
As always, thank you, Gracia.
Thanks, girlfriend. All right, more ET Live next. But first, he's a comedian, an Oscar